Hi class, today we're going to take a look at multiplying and dividing rational expressions. First, we need to take a look at what a rational expression is. And basically, it's a fraction that has a polynomial in the numerator and the denominator. So for instance, if I had x plus 5 over x minus 2, that would be a rational expression. Because we have variables in the fraction, basically, because there's a polynomial on the top and the bottom. You could have also a rational expression that just looked like 2 over x plus 3. That would be fine also. Or you could have something as complicated as x squared plus 2x minus 5 over x squared minus 3x plus 4. These are all considered rational expressions because you have a polynomial in the numerator and the denominator. Now, we're going to take a look at multiplying and dividing, but before we get into that, I want to take a look at reducing these expressions. And in order to do that, we're going to take a little flashback to reducing regular fractions because these are just a fancy looking fraction. So let's say that you had something like 10 over 15. If you wanted to reduce this fraction, what you would do is look for something that goes evenly into both the numerator and the denominator. And I noticed that 5 divides evenly into 10 and 15. So what we might have done in a previous course was divide the top by 5 and also divide the denominator by 5, and we'd end up with 2 over 3. Another way to look at this is to actually rewrite the numerator and the denominator as factors. And we would break 10 into 5 times 2 and 15 into 5 times 3. When you reduce this way, you can easily see that the 5's cancel out because 5 over 5 is 1. So, writing it this way, we could cancel 5s, and what we're left with is 2 over 3. This second way that I showed you to reduce this fraction is almost identical to what we're going to take a look at with the rational expressions. The difference between this problem and a rational expression is the rational expression is going to be a little bit harder to see what the factor is. We could look at 10 and 15 and easily see that 5 went into them. But if you have something like x squared plus 5x plus 6 over x squared minus 9, it's a little bit harder to see what's going to cancel out. So we need to take and rewrite this expression here so that it's written as factors like we did right here with our 10 over 15. So we're going to factor the numerator and the denominator completely. Let's start with the numerator and just treat these as separate problems. If you look at the numerator, we don't have anything in common in any of these terms, or actually in all of those terms, because it would have to be for all of them. And there's three terms, and this leading coefficient here is 1. So we could do our shortcut for factoring. And just take a look at the 6 and ask ourselves, what would multiply to get a positive 6, and at the same time add up to this positive 5? And that would be 2 and 3. 2 times 3 is 6, and 2 plus 3 gives us that 5 there. So that means that the numerator is going to factor into an x plus 2 times an x plus 3. Now let's take a look at the denominator. The denominator also does not have anything in common with these two terms. But if you take a look at these two terms, they're both perfect squares. X squared is x times x, and 9 is 3 times 3. So this is a difference of squares because of the subtraction right here. So we can break this into x minus 3 times x plus 3. Once you have the numerator and the denominator broken into its factors, like we have here, you can easily see that there's a common factor of this x plus 3 in the numerator and the denominator. Just like the 5's canceled here, the x plus 3's will cancel in our numerator and denominator here. The key is to make sure that you have factored completely before you start canceling. Sometimes people want to go and start canceling these x squareds here, but you can't because of the pluses and minuses here. The opposite of division, which is what the fraction bar represents, is multiplication. So we have to have everything being multiplied in the numerator and the denominator as they are here when we've broken them into factors before we can cancel through this division of the fraction bar. So now we've canceled our x plus 3's and we can get our final simplified expression of x plus 2 over x minus 3. Now that we can reduce our rational expressions, we're going to be able to move on to our multiplying and our dividing. And in order to multiply and divide, what I would like to do is take a little flashback to multiplying our regular fractions, and then once we've finished multiplying expressions, we'll do the same thing for division. So let's say that you were going to multiply the fraction 25 over 36 with the fraction 24 over 35. You could multiply straight across and then try to reduce, but multiplying 25 and 24 is going to be much harder than if we reduced up front. And similarly, multiplying 36 times 35 is going to be very large also. And the larger the numbers, the harder it is to reduce. So let's go ahead and reduce up front by cross-canceling. We can find things that are one right over the other that have a common factor, or we can go diagonally. And I notice if I go diagonally, the 25 and the 35 can pair up because both of them have a divisor of 5. So what we're going to do is reduce those first. 5 goes into the 25 5 times, so we divide 5 into 25 and write down the answer. 5 goes into 35 7 times, so we cross it out, divide 5 into the 35, and write our answer down of 7. We've now reduced those two values to much smaller numbers by canceling out the 5s. Now let's look at what's remaining. We have a 5, a 24, a 36, and a 7 here. So I notice that if I want to find things that have common factors, if I go diagonally again, which I could go up and down or diagonally, that 12 goes into 36 and also 24. So I'm going to divide 12 into 36 and write down the answer of 3. And then I'm going to divide 12 into 24 and write the answer down of 2. Now I have much smaller numbers, and if I check out the remaining values of 5, 2 on the top, and 3 and 7 in the bottom, nothing can be paired up and canceled. So we can multiply straight across 5 times 2, which is much, much easier than multiplying 25 and 24. That gives me 10 in my numerator. And then I can multiply 3 times 7, which gives me 21 in the denominator. And this is your reduced fraction here, which is going to be our answer. Now, that process is going to be very similar for our rational expressions. However, since we won't have numbers, it'll be a little harder to see what divides evenly into everything. So let's take a look at a problem like x squared minus 49 over x squared plus 9x plus 14. And we're multiplying that rational expression by the expression x squared minus 4 over x squared minus 3x minus 10. Now, since we can't see what's going to cancel right away, what we're going to need to do is factor everything. So this is essentially four little factoring problems in one. We're going to start very systematically going one little part at a time. So first look at this x squared minus 49. I notice that's a difference of squares, and x squared is x times x, and 49 is 7 times 7. So this is going to factor into x plus 7, x minus 7. Now, I'm going to move to the denominator of this fraction. And this here has three terms. There's nothing in common, and this first term has a 1 in front of it. So we need to look at the factors of 14 that will add up to 9. And I notice that 2 times 7 is 14, and 2 plus 7 is your 9. So that means that this will factor into x plus 2 times x plus 7. Now that I have factored the numerator and denominator of that rational expression, let's move to the other one, breaking this problem into four smaller problems to help us out. Looking at this numerator here, I notice there's two terms, and x squared is x times x, and 4 is 2 times 2, and they're separated by a subtraction. So this is a difference of squares. It's going to factor into x plus 2 times x minus 2. Now, let's take a look at our last thing we need to factor for this problem. Right here, we have a trinomial. It's got three terms, and the leading coefficient is 1, and there's no common factors. So we need to look at this negative 10 here and see what will multiply to get a negative 10, and at the same time add up to the negative 3. And I notice that if I take a look at 2 times negative 5, that will be a negative 10, and 2 plus negative 5 is my 3. So that means that this is going to factor into x plus 2 times x minus 5. Now, everything is broken down into its factors, so we can see what can cancel. Basically, you just need to pair something up in the numerator of one of them with something in the denominator that are so that they're like terms and we can cancel. So in other words, this x plus 7 here will cancel with that x plus 7. Now, I notice that there's an x plus 2 right here in my numerator. And I have an x plus 2 down here. I also have one over here. Since there's only one in the numerator, we can only cancel one of these in the denominator. It does not matter which one you choose, just as long as you only do one of them, because you only have one in the numerator. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel this one with that one. And if I look at what's remaining, nothing's in common. So we can't cancel anything with the numerator in the numerator with something in the denominator. So now, our final solution is going to be x minus 7 times x minus 2 over x plus 2 times x minus 5. And you can leave it in factored form unless the problem asks you to not do that, but normally it is perfectly fine to leave it in factored form. So your final answer would be this right here.